Hey there, friends and enemies, Joper here again, and today I wanted to talk about the choices between the Ravager and the Doe in Remnant 2 because they are very interesting and lead to a variety of different rewards, so you're going to have to do this multiple times if you want to earn everything. But first and foremost, you're going to have to do the Water Harp Puzzle. This is not overly complicated, but you got to remember, you got to proceed through the entirety of the adventure, the campaign, in order to get back to the Water Harp Puzzle, which you'll see initially, but won't be able to activate. Once you see it the second time, there's actually in the building next to the Water Harp Puzzle, you go up the stairs around the back and you're going to pull a lever. Then you can go forward, do the puzzle. I'm going to show you which slots all the pegs need to go into. It's pretty simple once you get that down, but definitely check out a full video guide on the Water Harp Puzzle if you're confused. You're going to pull the lever next to the puzzle, and then the bridge is going to form on the left, which is going to lead you to the Ravager. Now, this is where things get very interesting. The Ravager is going to do a bunch of exposition where they talk to you, and then you're going to have a decision to make on whether to shoot the doe or not. So if you shoot the doe, this is going to give you a variety of different things. First and foremost, two achievements. The first being only human, where you kill a boss without taking any damage. This is one of the harder achievements in the game or trophies if you don't have it. So definitely do that if you are looking for that, if you are a trophy hunter and having problems beating a boss without taking any damage. The second one is going to be the was this supposed to happen, where you get the alternate boss kill reward. So those are both achievable by just killing the doe straight out. You actually don't have to fight the Ravager at all. And you're going to also get the Ravager's Mark Amulet. This is great for bleed builds, and it has the following ability. It allows you to increase your overall damage to enemies inflicted with bleed. The damage is increased further if the enemies you attack are at half of their maximum HP or lower than that. Now, one of the rewards, and the reason I went with killing the doe from my very first playthrough, is the fact that I read online that you would actually be able to get a permanent blood moon if you kill the doe. This is not the case. You will not get a permanent blood moon. It will still be a random chance, so don't take that to heart. You won't be able to farm the blood moon essence or anything like that, so that's something to keep in mind, and I know it plays into the decision, because while the Ravager's Mark Amulet is good, it's really only great for bleed builds, so if you're not doing a bleed build, you'd probably want to go in a different direction. Now, the second option is actually reviving the doe. You can use one of your relics in order to bring it back up. You'll see a nice little cutscene, and then you're going to have to fight the corrupted Ravager. This one is very, very interesting because the boss fight is really hard, and despite the cutscene, the Ravager starts at full health, and so it's going to be the hardest boss fight of all of the options. Though you are going to get the Doe's Antler. This can be used to craft with Ava McCabe the Red Doe Staff. It's a melee weapon that has a lifeline. This allows you to charge the staff and do a huge load of damage with the following attack after stacking up a certain amount of damage. The staff also heals your allies to a certain extent as you are fighting. This is very good. I think this is one of the better melee weapons in the game, especially as a support character. So I highly recommend chasing that if you are doing support builds. But then you have the next option where you can just shoot the Ravager. The Ravager is then, as you are fighting it, going to try to eat the doe. You can either have it eat the doe, which is going to give you one reward, or you can shoot the doe yourself, which is going to give another reward. How someone figured this out is beyond me, but it is pretty interesting. So if you do have the Ravager eat the doe, you're going to get the Crimson Membrane. This is going to be taken back to Ava McCabe and allow you to craft the Merciless Long Gun. This is one of the best weapons in the game. I highly recommend chasing this. It is the one that I would chase first and foremost if I was playing the game fresh, because it is that good, and I definitely think you should get it. Comes with the Bloodline ability, which allows you to shoot a projectile of pure energy that tears through anything in front of it. Very nice. Then you can also shoot the doe, like I said. This will give you the Ravager's Maw. This allows you to craft a melee weapon called the Feral Judgment Melee, a Feral Judgment. You cannot receive all four rewards on those same playthrough. This seems obvious, but just keep that in mind, because you're going to have to do multiple playthroughs of this. You can do it either in a campaign, you can do it in adventure mode, or you can join a co-op mode as well and join a friend who makes a different decision and allows you to get a different reward, because all of these are going to be very, very different. So overall, I love this idea of the multiple rewards, but also the fact that The options are all very, very good depending on what type of build you're making. And you also, if you save the dough, you can go back to the pan that's playing the music. He will grant you additional rewards. There are also additional chests at the back of the boss room, which whether you defeat the boss, you kill the dough, no matter what you do, you can get those as well. Keep that in mind because those are going to give you some extra materials. But overall, yeah, this is probably the most difficult decision to make in the game, and with all the different options, it's really good to know what you can possibly get, because all of these rewards are useful in their own right, very viable for different builds, and you're going to want to chase each and every one of them down at some point in your playthrough. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, helps me out tremendously, shows you want to see more Remnant 2 content from me going forward. I really do appreciate it. I hope you are enjoying the game as much as I have. It's been an absolute blast. My name is Jopa. I hope you have a good one. I'll catch you all later. He's dead. Go forth, cub, dealer of death. Remember what it takes to profit from